Shri Manish Gupta ji.
So the Public Premises Eviction of Unauthorized Occupant Bill 2019 Amendment Act. Sir, we have observed in this amendment that there are several infirmities and several assumptions which have been made to obviate the obvious problem of overstay in government accommodation by several categories of persons who are allotted such accommodation. So, this matter needs a holistic view. Holistic view in the sense that in the short term, attempts are being made to vacate accommodation in a summary fashion. Now, if you look at the government apparatus, more than 12% of the GDP is spent on government employees. The reason is that whether it's the state government or the central government, the multifarious schemes that are required to be executed requires a lot of manning, lot of officers, lot of ministerial staff, and to assist in the delivery systems to the people. It is very important. The government functions on the apparatus. So now, the government accommodation also, the stock of the government accommodation, we do not find anything in the bill or in the objects and reasons or what the Honorable Minister has stated in the Lok Sabha or here that the stock is needed to be built up. The shortages are emanating from the fact that certain large number of the accommodation is being blocked, but addition to the stock is not being done. When lakhs of crores are being spent in the budget, why cannot more funds be allotted to build more accommodation on a yearly basis, slowly build up the stock so that this kind of a situation doesn't arise? This kind of a situation where you are trying to bring in summary procedures. So this legislation was amended on 5 earlier occasions, as you have kindly said. That only goes to show that what I had said earlier, holistic view. Why do you have to keep amending the law so frequently? There is a need to take a total view of matters. And the fixed tenure system, you have said here, the, you see, the certain sections of this bill has not been properly drafted. Leaves a lot to be desired. You have said that the period he is in office. Period he is in office means that person could be a joint secretary to a department. He may change his accommodation, but he still continues as a joint secretary. So he says the period that he is allotted the accommodation, this should be revisited, reworded. Now these 3 days notice period, the estate officer here has been given unbridled powers. Estate officer, unbridled powers to decide when to give the notice, to give a notice, and then to execute the notice. So payment of damages is another big issue here. Payment of damages, nowhere in the proposed amendments or in the Act, it has been mentioned as to how these damages are to be calculated. If you are referring to a monthly rent, that should be clearly stated. If you say damages, it gives a blanket power to the estate officer to levy anything he wants. This is not a quasi-judicial proceeding. Through this bill, that power could not be given to the estate officer, yet you have given him summary powers. Now, so therefore the damages are not quantified. In Section 5 of this Act, 15 days are given for vacation of public premises. But in this bill, for residential accommodation, this allowance has not been given. 3 days is too small a time. Clause 4, separate estate officers may fix separate amounts for separate accommodations in separate places. So there's an inconsistency. This must be standardized because there are no guidelines regarding this. So I think this should be included in the subordinate legislation, that is the rules. Section 3BA gives you 3 working days. And it says, shockingly, I was surprised to see this provision, that you can affix a notice on the door of the flat. It almost sounds as if you are going through a criminal proceeding. Criminal proceedings, even for absconders, there is a provision in the CRPC that notice can be plastered on the door. But in the case of an officer who is under a law which is nothing to do with crime, a criminal option has been taken by plastering the notice. Even it goes on to say that the notice can be fixed in any other prominent place. So I think officers should not be treated in this fashion. I think we should take a more lenient view. The estate officer, this designation of powers, delegation of powers to the estate officer. So this is very disturbing because the estate officer, I don't know what rank he would, has not been clearly mentioned. Estate officer, you have not described who estate officer can be, which cadre can he belong to, what should be his pay scale, what is his status. So any junior officer, if he's appointed estate officer, is very likely to be more arbitrary than one would imagine. So sir, this, and there are other things like, so you have got a cabinet subcommittee for accommodation. And you have mentioned that the cabinet subcommittee would deal with such cases. But I think the cabinet subcommittee would not have time to go into details. Every case, this whole issue is a case-by-case basis. So case-by-case basis, you should have a special committee or an empowered committee so that all the extenuating circumstances, all the compassionate grounds, all the issues that need to be treated with care, the cabinet subcommittee will not be able to execute this. So in the interest of the government as well as the incumbent, this matter should be taken up so that the cause of natural justice and such other issues that need to be taken into account. You have also mentioned, now, as I was saying earlier, this housing accommodation. You need to increase the stock. The law should be revisited. Even here in Section 7, the wording is, if a person is unauthorized occupation of resident accommodation, challenges the eviction order passed by the estate officer under subsection 2 of section 3B in any court, he shall pay damages for every month. So it appears as if he goes to court, he is going to be punished. If he takes the option of a fundamental right, he is going to be punished for going to the court. It reads like that. I don't think that is your intention. If that is not your intention, sir, we'd be very grateful if you revisited this section and redrafted it. Thank you. Thank you.